Hello everybody, today I thought we would take a trip down memory lane in a bit because I started YouTube after I've actually collected all my unusual weapons, as some of you may know from some of my episodes or special videos where I've been talking about that thing. But therefore I don't really have like previous to that, so I wanna share that with you today, even though I mean this would have made a perfect 10k sub special, but I'll have to find another idea for that. But I felt like this would be a very good idea, and therefore I'll share it with you. So we're gonna just start as far back as backpack.tf will take us for now, and that's this state 2014, and I've sorted it by value here, and we'll just quickly go over the items here so you can see them. As said, these are just value. When we get a bit into the future, I'll just have it by how it's sorted by the backpack, because unusual weapons doesn't add up with value, just so you can see that. So already way back as far as we can go, you may notice, like, I don't think there's anything more valuable down here, but let's just go back up here again. But you may notice that I currently, pretty sure that I currently at least have all unlockables in Strange already. So my goal for that were already completed back then. So that is pretty nice indeed. But I mean this is not that interesting yet, but keep that in mind. Let's go to the end of the year, as in just before 2015. Okay, so here we are at the end of the year, and I've managed to get myself a few unusuals, as you can see here. Four unusuals, one of them being the HHA, so that's three actual unusuals. And we're just gonna go ahead and sort it by value, like the other one were. And another thing that I've gotten is I've gotten my Australian Venture, or how it were back then. And another thing to notice as well, now that we have this up, I actually had a lot of kills on my Widowmaker back then, but if you see my current one, it's only at like, what, 2,000-3,000, I don't know. So of course I reset that when because I went into some new parts, so it were easier to just reset, even though I could have transferred the kills, but that would just look odd. So if anybody were wondering, probably my favorite primary weapon in the game is the Widowmaker. Just, well, I mean, I really love the Frontier 2, but it's just, I think the Widowmaker beats it just because you can keep firing, I don't know. It just feels better, I guess. But I also really like the Frontier Justice a lot. But as you can see, I've gotten a few Australiums, but just for my engineer, of course. Other than that, it looks pretty decent. It looks like a pretty okay backpack, doesn't it? So, gonna scroll down here a bit, just, like, it just starts getting down to worthless things, just so you can have a good look here. And let's try and jump forward, like, to the end of next year, meaning, like, the end of 2015. Okay, so we are at the end of 2015 now. We have no need to sort by value, but we can see here's an unusual. Here we have my scattergun as well, and that's the HHH. Of course, this is strange now. I don't think it was in the previous ones. And then we have my rocket launcher too. This was my old minigun, and we have the what is it called, medigun 2. It's because like the one I have now is a tough break only, but I had one gunmetal. Then we have my two sniper rifles. We've also gotten the anger here, and flamethrower of course, and then pyro set as well here. Then got my spy revolver too. Just overall got nicer things, like I also got smoking on spy, and you may have noticed some like other things around here and there, like I think I don't think I covered that before, but yeah. Then I've also got a shotgun and my pistol of course, and overall it's starting to look more like it is today. It's like looking pretty good, pretty okay here. And then of course my NG heads, like my NG set is complete in that sense, because at this time there's no, you know, unusual rents, so just overall all nice. But what exactly happened? And we are gonna go back to like mid early gun, or not mid, but more like very early gunmetal, short after I figured out that unusual weapons can actually also be strange. Okay, so this is about 5 months earlier, so it's like gunmetal hit recently, and you can see the date here. So gunmetal hit recently, and it's like I just figured out, oh, you can actually get them in Strange Unusual. We have the conga here, we of course have a lot of strange. Look, I've even started to start like getting the skins as well, like factory new skins, because I had that beforehand. You can see there's the SMG I had. I actually just had picked this up recently, so I didn't want to get a skin sniper rifle as an example. I had a shell shocker here, minimal wear. Didn't really want to go for factory. I had an Australian nade launcher. Had one of these sudden flurry. I think this is my favorite cancer skin, I want to say, but you know, sticky bomb launcher. I don't really like the sticky bomb launcher that much as a weapon concept. And then I've got this medigun here. Got this minigun. Then down in Pyro, I didn't have like an unusual Pyromancer's mask, but I had the smoking Wraithwrap at this time. This is the skin I had for, well, Spy, and then we had this skin for Pyro before unusual, of course. And this is the old pistol. I'm actually kind of regretting to have sold this now. Just would be nice to still have it, but I think it got back ban removed when I checked up. I wanted to kind of buy it back, but that's not gonna happen. It had like a very nice decoration pattern thing, so it would just have been nice to still have in a way, but I mean, I still have my Dahlias, but it's because I really like the Dahlias, so it would also be nice to have a factory new strange one, and maybe at some point even give it away. Could have been nice too, but that's not what we're looking at. We're looking at that I actually picked up my first strange unusual weapon, which is the shotgun that is now my Pyros. Back then I had it added like both for Engineer and Pyro. I'm not sure how many kills I got it up to, but probably about the 2k before I reset it and made it a Pyro one. Of course, this is the kills from back at the time period that we are in. And I also picked this one up. Halloween hadn't hit yet, so I didn't have the like Ancient Eldritch one, because the other one is like the end of October, which means after Halloween, so just there's that. And I still had this. I was like, I'm not sure if I had it on the other history too, but I were gonna sell this at some point, but still had this because but I still use this combo here with Engineer, like these three items. Let's go like to like a month or something a bit later, you know, like half into gunmetal or something, and look at it there. Of course not 100% accurate in the middle of gunmetal, but around there. And let's just take a look down here. So no scattergun like we saw on the one like at the end of October, but we do have the sniper stuff there. Recently picked up the team captain or something, I guess. We have this, of course. Now tradable, of course, like it wasn't before. We also have like a few other things like this picked up. I picked that up early as well, but just not much difference. But we do have the pistol, which is important to keep in mind. So this is around the time where I, like probably a week or a bit after that, I've actually picked up this pistol, and I was getting ready to sell this one at that time again. Kind of wish I wouldn't have done that, but I don't think there's anything else like that we haven't touched on earlier that is worth noting here. But I just felt like doing a trip down memory lane in a sense, where nice, and then sharing it with you guys, and just, you know, enjoying it a bit, how stuff progressed, or how you'd call it. So there's that. Anyways, I hope everybody enjoyed this, and I'll see you again next time.